Okay, let's pick up from where we left off. And if you remember, we had enabled custom CSS. And when we do that, we have these custom themes buttons. And we also really quickly explored base mode, changing it from dark to light. So now we're in light mode. Here's kind of what the app looks like. This might be familiar to what you're used to when you're working with most of the apps until recently around. They've always been in quote light mode. It was just the only mode we knew. Now there's dark mode. I tend to prefer it too. I know it's trendy, but it is kind of nice, especially when you're looking at the screen for long hours. So for now, we're in dark mode and let's explore community themes. So what you do is you find a theme, you're just scrolling. Oh, this one's new. And we can click use. And so now we're in this custom theme, which is really big. I'll show you this hotkey later, but you can reduce the size on things. And you can kind of see what this looks like. Let's try a different one. Okay, so this is a really nice theme that's similar to the custom theme. And it has a really cool map. Okay, so these maps aren't showing up too well. If you noticed on my other screen, I have this pretty advanced looking setup. So I don't mean to go too crazy with this, but let's use it for this purpose. So this is part of what's called the LYT Kit, which is the Linking Your Thinking Kit. And this is a starter kit. So as you gain experience, you might think like, how do I connect everything? I use folders. Do I use tags? What can I use? Links, you know, to connect these ideas over time. It's easy when we have 50 notes, but when we have 500 and we have 5,000, it's a different story. So I created this kit to allow you to kind of figure out how that works. That'll be a different video and a whole different series. For now, though, let's use it to explore themes. So this is a custom theme. This is called Cybertron, which I created, and it's kind of like futuristic and stuff. You can see a little bit of the look. So what's kind of neat here is, remember bold? In this theme, bold is its own color. And you know, if we wanted something to be italicized, that's its own color. You can see the color for links. If we want to click on direction, that takes us to this direction note. If we click on four virtues, that takes us to this note. A lot going on here. Let's not just stay on this theme though. Let's go back to that really cool kind of Obsidian alternative theme by one of the Obsidian mods on the Discord forum, actually. So this is pretty cool. It's clean. It really takes advantage of that purple color. And if we look at the graph view here, it's a pretty cool looking thing. And we can click into any of these notes. Let's click into what are higher order notes. And here's the structure of a note. Now we're in edit view. And we can see this is a title, right? Just that single hash. We could add hashes and reduce the size, but that's a title. We'll keep it that way. Something else you might have noticed is this thing called the local graph. So any note I click on, and this is really wild, but we can see a local graph version of it here. I don't want to go into all those features, but we're just exploring the themes. Let's check out one more dark theme, and then we'll go into light mode, check out a few themes there, and just kind of show you what's possible. So this theme, this is a pretty cool theme. What's neat is members of this community, and you know, typically any community, they're creating themes that they enjoy. And so here's another one by a member of the community. And you can see the different headers are different colors. So that's an important thing. If, you know, for this theme, it's an important thing. Let's see what other colors there are. So, okay, pretty cool. Yeah, I can dig that. Let's stay in edit mode and let's go to appearance, and we're going to switch it to light mode. And let's check the community themes for light mode. So we've dealt with a lot of color, and this theme, as it happens, is clean theme. So let's check out clean theme, see what this looks like. So, I mean, if you're just used to dark mode, it's like, wow, you know, the irises are blown out. But after you get used to it, well, maybe something can be done with the graph view. But after you get used to it, it is going back to this attention note. You can see here's bold, here's italic, and we can see the different headers, the links that we can go to different nodes. So this is a pretty minimal theme. The idea with a minimal theme is it's great because it's just you and the text. So you can actually just work on your ideas and write. That's what we want to do. We want to have a little bit of fun, yes, but then we want to get back to writing, thinking, and linking. So let's check out maybe just one more. Scrolling through. Why not this one? By another Obsidian mod. And this is the light mode version of it. So we see, let's check out the different titles. Okay, all one color, which is an off black. And then we get into our text. If there's a link, it's a lighter color. And let's jump back to this attention note. Here's bold, here's italic. So I think you get the idea. Like, this can be fun, you can lose hours in this, you can design your own. But it shows you the versatility and the power that you can have as the graphical interface in which you interact as you take your notes, as you make your notes. Hopefully you got something out of this video. It's a little bit different than the other ones because I think those other ones are a little bit more practical. This one's kind of, you know, fun. You can mess around with it, spend almost too much time. But it does harken to one of the really important reasons we do all this is that we want to have fun. We want the experience that we have as we manage our personal knowledge. We want it to be a joyous experience. And I have to say, when I go back to my Cybertron theme, which we'll do now, this brings me more joy than it should. Let me update that. This, for whatever reason, brings me a lot more joy than it should. I enjoy working. I'm more creative in this mode, but I know it's not for everyone. It's, you know, it's definitely an acquired taste. The point being is a theme can allow you to be more productive, but usually you waste a lot more time trying to find your perfect theme. So hopefully this gave you some ideas. Don't waste too much time on it, but have a little bit of fun. And if you like this video, there's going to be one more or two more in this series on the beginnings and the basics of using Obsidian. So if you're a complete beginner and you've liked these videos so far, you haven't subscribed, then please subscribe. If you haven't left a comment, I'd love to hear from you how I can improve these videos and what you've liked about them. Stay tuned for the next video. I hope to see you there.